Welcome back, pilots. I hope you're ready to dive into learning more about elapsed time. In our first lesson, we learned about the three different types of elapsed time problems. Can anyone remember what those three types of problems were? That's right. Great job. Today, we're going to learn how to use the number line strategy to help us solve the three different types of elapsed time problems. So buckle those seatbelts and let's get ready for takeoff. All right, pilots, now it's time to head into our training so that you can learn our strategy for solving elapsed time word problems. Here's what you'll need: your interactive notebook page or math notebook from the previous lesson and a pencil. Get your materials and let's get started. In our first lesson, we already determined that for the first problem in our notebook, we are trying to find how long the flight lasted. We know that the flight took off at 7:15 p.m. So I'm gonna go ahead and record my start time on the number line. And then what we're going to do is we are going to make jumps on our number line until we get to the end time, which we know is 8:30 p.m. I think about jumping an hour after 7:15 p.m. would put me at, what time do you think? Yeah, that would put me at 8:15 p.m. So let's go ahead and do an hour jump. And we're gonna mark that on our number line so that we can keep track of our times. Now I need to make it to 8:30 p.m. because that's the end time. So I'm gonna do a few more jumps and I am going to do 5 minutes at a time. So 8:15 plus 5 minutes would be 8:20 p.m. 8:20 plus 5 more minutes would be 8:25. And then 5 more minutes gets us to 8:30 p.m. So I'm gonna record that on my number line. So then what I need to do is count up my jumps to figure out how long the flight lasted. So I know I have 1 hour plus 5 minutes, 5 minutes, and 5 more minutes for a total of 1 hour and 15 minutes. So the flight lasted 1 hour and 15 minutes. Now let's take a look at our second sample problem. We know that we are solving for what time the pilot landed the plane. We are given a start time of the pilot starting to fly the plane at 8 a.m. So we're going to go ahead and record that on our number line. And then we are going to make our jumps across our number line for 2 hours and 30 minutes. So I'm gonna go ahead and do 1 hour jump, and that would put me at what time do you think on the number line? Yeah, 8 a.m. plus 1 hour later would be 9 a.m. Then I'm gonna do another hour jump. So 9 a.m. and 1 hour later would be 10 a.m. And then I know that I still need to jump another 30 minutes. So I'm gonna do one more jump. And then 10 a.m. plus 30 minutes later would get us at what time do you think? Good, 10:30. So we know that the pilot, after flying for 2 hours and 30 minutes, landed the plane at 10:30 a.m. Good job. Now let's head on to our last problem. And with our last problem, we know that we are solving for the start time, what time the plane took off. So in this case, we're actually going to start all the way on the right side of our number line and work backwards. So we know that the plane arrived, or Pat arrived, at her destination at 4 p.m. So we're gonna write 4 p.m. on our number line. and she had been on that flight for 1 hour and 45 minutes. So we are going to go ahead and jump 1 hour backwards. So 1 hour before 4 p.m., what time do you think that would be? Yeah, good job. That would be 3 p.m. So we're going to keep up with that on our number line. And then we still have to account for 45 minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and do a 30-minute jump just because that's a little bit easier for me to think about as I'm counting backwards. So 30 minutes before 3 p.m. would be what time do you think? Yeah, good, 2:30. So we're going to go ahead and keep track with that on our number line. So 2:30 p.m. And then we still have 15 more minutes to go. So I'm going to go ahead and use these little 5-minute jumps to go backwards. So I know I need 3. You could, as you're doing this, just do one big 15-minute jump, whatever's easiest for you. But 15 minutes before 2:30, what time do you think that would be? Good, 2:15 p.m. Good job. So we know then that the plane took off at 2:15 p.m. Now that you've gone through training, it's time to put your training to the test. We're going to pull out that worksheet that you did in the first lesson for practice, and we're going to finish it. So last time you went through and highlighted the start time, end time, and elapsed time for each problem. And today you are going to apply the strategy of using the number line to solve for whatever each problem is asking you to do. So go ahead and spend the next few minutes working through using your number line, practicing doing the jumps, and keeping up with your time as you move along, and let's see how you do. All right, pilots, you did a fantastic job navigating those bumpy airways. So now let's check our work. For problem number one, he needs to leave at 4:15 p.m. For problem number two, the flight was 1 hour, 55 minutes long. For problem number three, her plane took off at 8:45 a.m. And for problem number four, he landed the plane at 6:10 p.m. I hope you guys did a great job with this and continue practicing using that number line strategy as you solve elapsed time problems.
Wow, pilots, now that we've landed, I'm so impressed with how well you're using our new elapsed time strategies. I hope you take what you've learned from these two lessons on your next flight.